in group 1, I mean if you add the solution of HCl in group 1 and if you get the precipitates in group 1, then we should decide that what we can do or what we should do after getting the precipitates in group 1. Then we have to filter the precipitates of group 1 and we should go with these precipitates in the analysis of group 1. Friends, if we get the precipitates, then we think that how many cations are present in the mixture or which one is present, only one, two cations or more cations may be present in that precipitates. So we should take the PPTS for the group analysis of group 1. Okay, so group 1 cations follow flow chart. Now I would like to show, I would like to explain this flow chart for you. If you have the initial solid substance, that means if you have the precipitates from A group, then the initial solid substance you have to acidify with 2 molar HCl, and then if there are precipitates, first of all the precipitates of group separation, precipitates of present group 1, that PPTS must be acidified with 2 normal hydrochloric acid at this time, and then you have to filter, or we have to filter the solution with precipitates. If we have precipitates in a funnel, in a filter, in the filter paper, then precipitates may be of AgCl, silver chloride, which is white gaseous precipitate, or PbCl2, lead chloride, again white crystals are there. If the PPTS are white amorphous, then mercury chloride may be present. Okay, so precipitates may be of AgCl, PbCl2 or HgCl2. But if you are a student of PG, if you are a student of master degree, then you have to follow this. These precipitates may be of WO3XH2O. If the precipitates are yellow in color, dark yellow in color, at this time precipitate may be of tungsten oxide. Okay, if crystalline PPTS, then thallium also may be present. Okay, this is for PG students and the same is for UG students. So by this video, all the students from UG and PG can be benefited by this information. Okay, now this precipitates with the treatment with hot H2. You have to treat those PPTAs with hot water. Then you have precipitates again. So precipitates with hot H2 may be of HgCl2 or AgCl. Again, it may be of tungsten oxide, yellow PPTS. If it is yellow, then tungsten may be present. Solution must be go on. Okay, then this precipitates again treat with dilute ammonium hydroxide or liquor ammonia. If you get precipitates with ammonia or NH4OH, then the precipitates may be of HgNH2Cl, mercury amido chloride, then metallic mercury may be present. But in solution it contains AgNH3 twice plus. On this solution is carried out of the recognition of silver. You can go a test for silver. Okay, or you can go for the test of tungsten at this time. So crystals may be treatment with H2O. Then again you get the precipitates may be of mercury or Hg chloride or tungsten, right? Again the PPTS are treat with the liquor ammonia. If you get the precipitate, then precipitate may be of Hg or Hg may be present. Then the solution must be tested out for Hg, okay, or tungsten. Now if in this solution 0.1 normal Ki, if you get pale yellow color, then Hg plus may be present. Okay, then filtrate, evaporate plus 2 molar HCl, then 0.25 molar SnCl2, and then boil with concentrated HCl. If you get blue PPTS or color, the test indicates the presence of tungsten. Okay, if you get blue color in this test, then you can say that tungsten is present. But if you get pale yellow color with Ki with this solution, the solution gives pale yellow color with Ki, you can say that Hg plus is present, and this solution after evaporation acidify with HCl, then tin chloride, and then boil with HCl. If it is converted into blue color, you can say that tungsten is present. Then the treatment with hot water. Here these solutions, it goes to the second analytic group, okay, and then here group 1 cations flowchart treatment with hot water. Filtrate, filtrate from original solution. Okay, in this case analytic groups treatment with hot water. Filtrate may contain Pb plus 2 and Tl plus. Evaporate with concentrated sulfuric acid and then dilute with water and then cool down. Okay, filtrate with sulfuric acid, evaporate with sulfuric acid and then with water and then cool the solution. If there is a residue, so white PPTS, and if it is soluble in 6 molar ammonium acetate plus potassium dichromate, and if we get yellow PPTS which are soluble in acetic acid, then you can say that Pb plus 2 is present. But in case of filtrate of this residue, so filtrate, it must be neutralized with 2 molar ammonia plus 0.1 molar Ki. If it will give yellow precipitates which are insoluble in 0.5 molar Na2S2O3, that means thallium is present. So this is the specific test of thallium and this is the specific test of Pb. Okay, so this is the identification of group 1 or a special analysis of group 1. It is because in group 1 there are Ag, Hg, Pb and tungsten and thallium as rare elements. So students from PG department, they have to go for tungsten and thallium also. I hope this video can be very useful for you all the friends. If you like this information, then please like, share and subscribe Dr. Rajendra Dave Official on YouTube. Thank you.